Hi guys again, welcome to Neva's Garage. Today we're gonna continue with electrics on my bug. Let's do it. So I bought some new connections. Fuse box, connections, electrics. Very nice. Get some mosquitoes. Okay. So let's see, where were we? So we're gonna clear this mess out. This is the feeder cable for the washer, window washer, that we're gonna have two boxes. This is for the ignition, this is always power from the battery. So we're gonna connect that to ignition power, of course. So I'm gonna run it here somewhere. So as you can see, so this is the feeder from the bottom to the window washer. I'm gonna make an installation like this and hook it up here. So I think we're gonna cut it here somewhere. So, I'm gonna put on the new ring terminals. Well, that worked fine. About the shadows. Yeah. Try again. So, we're gonna go on. little the blue for the blue, but I think I have to go to the red, so which is smaller crimper. Let's try that one. So let's see if it's better up. Now it's very nice. I can connect it here. Guys get the idea, of course. Dishes. We're gonna have a fuse, maybe a, what do you think, 10 amps. Let's put a 10 amp right there. So let's continue. That one, these ones, maybe we should just hook up. I'm gonna try bundle up some cables here. Just does not have to be so. Let's see. This yellow. Thank you. Wrong cable. This is the LED LED flasher relay. Just in and out, and the small one is for the LED light for the turn signal in the instrument cluster. So we're gonna find a good place for this one, I guess. This is the flasher relay. The headlights relay, I'm sorry. I'd like to have it back to the original place. Squish this a little bit, see it's better. So, here is the original place. So we have to do this guy a little bit longer. Some tools. So you're gonna have to have a little bigger wire. So we're gonna have, let's see. Good. Let's put on a crimper. That one is finished. Where do I put the lighter? So let's crimp. So this side, put it out. Looks good. Ah, of course I need a ring terminal on the other side. Yeah. God damn it. So do it again and do it the right way. So let's put on the crimper. I think we can, let's see, cut this one too. Something like that. So I can pull it over here. And reinstall it. This is the feeder for the fuse box. This is the, I think it's the headlight, high beam, left and right. And now we're gonna do the same thing over here for the low beam cable. Thank you. it's there. A little bit of gas. Thermals a little bit loose. So much better. Now we're gonna tackle the next one. So, as I said, it's two relays, one headlight relay, one for the high beam, low beam, one go. Will feed the low beam left right, not sure if this one or this one, fuse box, and the other one is the this one for the headlights, high beam, low and high. So main relay for the, when you turn on the ignition, this gets power to the relay that starts the fuse box power to it. So we're gonna route this a little bit better. Crimper on it. Super crimper. And try this out. This is the main harness from the car. This was the old main feeder. We're gonna use it for something else. Not decided yet. For the rear lights, I guess. Okay, this is for the earth cable to the rear lights and so on. So this is located here. Takes earth from the meter up here. Okay. Try to reroute that one a little better. I think we can cut it. This earth we can reroute to the fuse box earth. Looks a little better. Here somewhere. Yeah. action. This one that went to the rear lights. I guess we can sorry about the birds, they like to be in the garage. Fly here in sometimes. Let's see. This one. I can show this one up. Something like that. Or should we do a in the tube, eller the electrovirus, and it has some melting solder, so you can it will crimp and solder the cables together. I don't think you're gonna use it now, because it might be good to have the cable still if I need to reroute it. So here is for the flasher, turn signals I mean, sorry. I think we're gonna, let's see, maybe we can take this one over, something like that. This comes from the steering column, goes into the flashers, the turn signals. So one is for the front and the rear. This is for the left side. So we're gonna I'm gonna tape it just for so that they don't come loose when driving. About the birds, I think it's mating season. This was the brake cable. Put some tape on it too. No, the art for the brake. I'm sorry. So I can turn it on the side too. And let's see. Good. Looks good. Yeah. Right side has fallen off. The flasher. Let's see, where were we? Where did it go? Over here, okay. Let's assist for the underside, for the right flusher. So, and need the extension this cable, it's short. We can try to solder it. This and extend it. This is right flasher. Again, extend it. I'm gonna try the solid stuff. It works. Never done this before, so. Yes, we should take a blue one, maybe. Yes, you do it like this. Have to crimp it. My hands off. Well, that did not work too good. Maybe I was too fast, so. Jank it off. Try again. Put the crimper on it also. Extra protection. might be not be so cleaned. Copper, old copper wire. Try again. Let's take another one of those guys. And let it cool down. Yeah, I think it's cool enough. Let's try it again. It actually works. Cool. Very good. Need to put extra shrimper on it. The cable a bit longer, maybe. Let's see, where is the connection? There, maybe like that. This one, if you want to, I got it from Amazon. Good. So now we can take it up here. Here somewhere. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. So now we can connect it again to the this one. Something like that. Put some tape on it. Something like that. I guess it works. So we can turn this also on the plate. This one is looking good. Looking good. That looks good. Let's see what more do we have here. This one looks good. Tab like that. This light. Is this one brown? Where should it go? Ron Brown. Mr. Brown, where you wanna go? So, now we found the brown cable, which go, it's over here. Over here. But we need an extension on it. Got it up here. So let's cut this one too. So I don't got any brown cable, too bad. Let's try again. One of those. Do So we're gonna need how much up there is new. It's good. Too small. God damn it. Come on. Of course not. So, one little ticker so that doesn't go to the ground, shorten out. Good. So now we can connect this one that comes from the behind. Over here somewhere. These guys are a little stiff. Oh. So, let's see, we have one more here, and this one, these guys are connected. High beam, low beam. It's too short. Make a new one. Extension. So, let's burn it. Something like that. Feed this one. Let's see. So let's see if you rewrote it under here somewhere. Light, high beam warning light, and it's on the right side. That means it should be here on the left side. Over here. So I don't know. Much better at all. Yeah, I don't think so, but I guess it works. Oh, but it's almost finished. We need to do some grounds for the boxes. These ones are the grounds. So you can take out grounds on these. So we're gonna figure that out. So we're gonna do a ground connection for the fuse boxes. I'm gonna take the one from the tank, mount him. Those. We need a washer. That that. Gonna route it up here. Also need a ground to the other box. I make a dual cable. I don't have left of any of the big cables. Thank you. Good. 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 So now we're gonna connect. From this box, it's grounded to the chassis. So take off this hole a little bit. Perfect. Something like that. Well, almost finished. Maybe not the prettiest, but it works. We're gonna do a little better. We're gonna tie up the cables and stuff. We got a little bit cleaner. We're gonna use the old positive side from the generator is cut. We're gonna maybe run the tachometer, and we're also gonna use this one. It's a black one. I think it's a cable. Gonna need oil pressure and lots of other stuff, so we're gonna also mount the new gauges. So this is the result, maybe not the prettiest, but it's gonna work. Lots of fuse boxes. This is the, for the original setup. This is extra for the battery, continuous power, and this for ignition power. The ignition power is hooked up by a 100 amps relay. So when you turn on the from the key, it will ignite, it will start the relay getting through from the big cable up here. This will do it so it closes. It puts the current through to the ignition power. The second one is from the battery directly, the car. This is also fused with 100 amps in the rear by the battery, and it's directly fed to the this box. This is for the rear lights. This is for the headlights, low or high beam, I don't remember. And this is also for the headlights, high or low beam, some of those. This is the ignition fuse for the original. So, that's it. We're gonna continue with the other meters, volt, fuel gauge, and we have oil temp and oil pressure switch we're gonna hook up. We're gonna throw some new cables for that, and we're also gonna hook up the camera, or the radio. Radio has also rear view camera. You can hook that one up too. So we're gonna mount the new gauges. We have the new fuel, have the battery and the oil pressure and the oil temperature. So we'll connect that, and we're gonna connect the stereo car, and we're gonna finish the electrics also. We have a half hour meter here. We're gonna make a new bracket for the hood opening somehow. So, thank you guys for watching today, and hope you all gonna have a nice day.